What's going on, everybody? This is the second tutorial for linked lists. This will be a short video, and in this video we are going to print a linked list again, but from reverse. What I mean by that is, we'll start out from the tail node first, printing out tail node first, and till the head node. So it will go like 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's assume that we have no knowledge about linked lists, and this is just an algorithm question we are trying to solve. There's actually some simple way to do this. We can use a stack or vector and push our all of data in our vector or stack, and after that we'll just traverse from reverse and print out all of the nodes. This is not the efficient way, but we'll do it anyways, and after that we'll solve it with recursion, and you'll see that recursion is really powerful in linked lists than for or while loops. Alright, so let's use a vector here. You can use stack if you want. It will go like this. Let's call this print linked list reverse. It will have one parameter again, linked list node pointer, and it will hold the value of head. So let's create our vector here now. Since we created a vector, our while loop will be the same as forward traversal. But now we are just not printing out the node first, we are just pushing it in our vector. And after this, we need to update our head node. So now our vector holds all the values of linked list in a forward fashion way. We need to reverse this. We can just write a simple for loop that starts from the last index till the first index. For int I equals v.size minus 1, and I will go until it's 0, 0 included, and it will decrement by 1. And we are just going to print out the vector's value in it, and we'll just simple end line here. Alright, so after this, I'm calling this function print linked list recursive and give the head node to it, print linked list reverse. Sorry, so let's try it if it is working well. As we can see, 4, 3, 2, 1, our linked list reverse function is working well. However, guys, this is a really bad way to write this because we are using extra memory here. We can do this really simple with recursion and without no extra space, just O1 of memory space, and it will go like this. I'll give you a hint. If you want, you can pause the video and think of it yourselves. In our print linked list recursive function, if you just copy and paste one line, the code will work perfectly. So I'll just copy this function to not write it again. And now I'll call this print linked list reverse recursive. Also, we need to change our function call name to. If you couldn't find it, this is the answer. If you delete line 54 to 55, if you swap these two lines, this code will work. So let me explain the logic behind it. In the forward fashion way, we first print out the head's data, and after that we update our head to the next node. And in the reverse function, we first call the function first. Therefore, without printing the data, it will recursively call itself until the head is a null pointer. And after that, since it can't call itself again, it will print out the data. Therefore, we made a simple reverse linked list function. Just swapping two lines work out like magic. And let's try it now. Print linked list reverse recursive, and we'll give the head node to it. As you can see, we got the 4, 3, 2, 1 again. And recursive functions really work well with classes. In binary trees, recursive functions work much better than for loops do. So if you don't know recursion, please learn it. Maybe I'll make a tutorial on recursion too. This is the simplest way to reverse iterate a linked list. So see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye.